Before we introduce you to our next guest, want to let you know market is down right now 52 points. But one of the things that's hot that everyone's talking about, it's called vaping, e-cigarettes. And joining us right now is a woman who's just opened Manhattan's first e-cigarette store. Tell us about this and welcome, by the way.
Hi, how are you? My name is Spike. I run Vape New York, Advanced Electronic Cigarette Company.
And you brought one with you?
I brought a couple.
Oh, okay. My goodness. They're actually attractive to look at.
Some of them are very pretty, and they have little designs that can be customized.
You customize. Bottom line for smokers, do you get the same buzz off of this as you would a regular cigarette?
Well, you know, it's a different kind of feeling. You're feeling the same hit of, like, you're smoking a cigarette and you're getting your nicotine delivery, but it's in a more efficient and cleaner way.
So what does that mean, then, for the whole cigarette culture, the bars, the nightlife, the whole thing? I mean, are people actually using these, pulling them out of their pocketbooks, or...?
They do use them in bars. I mean, one of the biggest problems with the bar owners is that they lost a lot of customers who had to step outside to smoke a cigarette. And that is not the case anymore, because this don't make any smoke. They make steam.
So, I mean, there is legislation going on right now to prevent use of those indoors, right? In New York, is that going to be
a problem?
They've tried.
Could it hurt our business? I don't think it will pass, because scientifically there's no justification for it.
Well, the FDA, I think, has put out warnings about this stuff, but again, there isn't really any research as of yet. It's nicotine, which isn't essentially good for you.
Well, the FDA warnings are based on a 2009 preliminary review. They're not based on an actual scientific published journal study. All of the journal studies that have come out in the last 5 years show that e-cigarette vapor is not toxic. So
a pack of cigarettes in New York City costs a lot. I don't know if the top...
About $15.
Okay.
$15,
About $1.50 a pack to use.
All right. And so you're opening the very first store in Manhattan.
Correct.
What's the demand been like? What's your traffic like?
We have a store in Queens, and people have been waiting for a store in Manhattan.
Okay.
And our Manhattan store, since we've opened about 8 days ago, has done a ridiculous amount.
Well, I heard you just took an order for $15,000.
That was actually a misquote. We placed an order for $15,000, and it's not arrived yet. We're almost out of product.
Sales of this stuff going to be about $1 billion in the United States. You wouldn't have opened the store if you didn't think you were going to cash in on this.
That's what they say, is that it should hit $1 billion this year, which I fully expect. The numbers of growth rate financially is exponential, because the number of users is growing exponentially. So people are... One person tells two other people, tells four other people, tells 10 other people, and it multiplies so quickly that you can't handle, the supply is not there for the demands. People want them, and they're just becoming harder and harder to get because so many people are buying them.
All right.
Thank you so much.
We appreciate it. Spike Babayan, good luck to you. I guess we're going to have to redo all those songs, like Pass the Dutchie on the Left-Hand Side or whatever it
was. I don't know if they're...